These jasmines, they're quite a large family, and as I look more into them, I found out that there are quite a few varieties in India. I've already covered two varieties. Then this is the third one. That is, it's called as... Jasminium multiflorum, and common name is downy jasmine. This down means that those leaves, they have a kind of a fine hair on them, so that's why it's called downy jasmine, that common English name. And in Kannada, magi mallige, and Sanskrita, kundaha. This one is a large hairy shrub that can climb on and to all bigger bushes and all that. And most of the plant has that velvety pubescence and the leaves also, and simple and slightly hairy leaves. Then flowers are mildly fragrant, they are not highly fragrant. You can get some mild aroma only. And they are found in large parts of Western Ghats, lower hills. And in many forests also they are found. This Jasminium multiflorum. Then it's also used in Ayurveda. That is, the dry leaves are used for ulcers. Like persistent type of ulcers. That is, these dried downy leaves. And then flower is the main herbal item here. And flowers are sweet, bitter, acrid, refrigerant. That means it's a very, very cooling for the system. And it's also laxative, cardiotonic, blood purifier, and digestive medicine, these white flowers, dried white flowers. Then mainly it's used for vitiated pitta and inflammation, rheumatism, and headaches. Then it has black fruits, like little berries. There's one there. These little berries. And I think birds are eating these fruits and spreading them around for seeds. There's some more seeds here. So this is a very, very pretty, attractive jungly jasmine. And one more thing I wanted to show, there's another type of jasmine also that's growing in the same bush only. This one has shiny leaves and not having that hairy pubescence. Whereas this is having the hairy pubescence. Oh, it's a beautiful thing, plant.